A documentary making waves at film festivals across the world highlights some of the most passionate young activists in this country and the events that inspired them. We talked to the filmmaker about why he decided to tell this story in ways other young people can engage in issues they care about.
Wow, that is a clip from The Day I Had to Grow Up, a documentary about youth activism in America, which won first place at the Prague International Film Festival. The film showcases six activists and the events that shaped their political lives, including the Parkland shootings, student debt, the climate crisis, and more. Joining us now with more insight into what was uncovered in the film and to share five ways our youth can engage more in activism is one of the co-directors and producers, Stefano Defray. Good morning. Thank you for being here all the way from France.
Good morning, Kendall. Thank you for having me.
Well, congratulations on this film. You are in Cannes right now because this was just showed at the Cannes Film Festival. How was it received there?
Extremely positively. You know, there are so many topics that people care about that are covered in the doc, but particularly, I would say, gun violence in America and climate change. You know, climate crisis affects all of us, and it doesn't matter whether you live on the Western Hemisphere or the Eastern Hemisphere, we are all affected by the rising temperature of this planet. Since we've been recording summers, this has been the hottest four summers on record since we've been recording it. And you see a lot of these issues in our documentary, The Day I Had to Grow Up. So it was received extremely well.
Well, just in these few moments in talking with you, you can tell that you personally have a passion for these issues as well. Why did you decide to make a documentary about this, not only about activists, but about really young activists in our country?
Yeah, you know, I feel sympathetic towards the Gen Zers. I had a watershed moment for 9/11, when that was like a kind of a watershed moment when I was growing up. Yeah. And I think a lot of the school shootings from Sandy Hook all the way to Parkland and all the things that happened in Colorado also as well, those had impacts on this generation. So I think that, you know, we tend to be a little bit more severe on a generation that's younger than us because of social media, mm-hmm. because of the availability of it, and to see them as sort of not as informed. But in fact, this film really spotlights the ins and outs of them as individuals and human beings. And I think that that's part of the benefits of a film like this. It opens up a dialogue to feeling that we're not so different. We're more alike than we are different.
One instance of some of these activists that you're talking about in the few minutes that I was able to watch, Stefano, these kids or these young adults were directly impacted, witnessed one of them, one of her friends, and correct me, was it the Parkland shooting?
Her friend,
who was right next to her, helped her shield her from a bullet with a book.
Right, she was using a book.
Her friend ended up dying.
Yeah.
What was it like interviewing people like that who, I mean, obviously this affected their entire life going forward and how they live?
Well, you start off as a filmmaker, you know, very compassionately with your subjects because you know that there's a lot of trauma there. So you start off slowly and you try to find out how comfortable they are to talk to you. Mm-hmm. If they're comfortable, you try to develop a relationship with them. And I was very lucky with Taylor in particular that we had become friends ahead of time. So before we started shooting, we had really developed a rapport, and she felt more and more open to share the story about Helena Ramsey, who was the girl who was killed, who saved not just Taylor's life, but she saved, you know, two other girls.
Yeah.
So this person was really a hero, and that's another part of the documentary that we're very proud of, you know, to showcase some of the unsung heroes in this world and kids who, you know, it should never be a thought that you're going to get shot when you're going to school. And you know, it's a very, very important part an important message in the documentary.
I think about what I was worrying about and thinking about and spending my time doing when I was their age. Right. It is amazing. It is so compelling and chilling to watch too. We have less than 1 minute. And I want to make sure we get to this, Stefano. You have five ways that our youth, other youth, can engage in activism. What are they? Will you run through them quickly for us?
Absolutely. You know, the first thing is to organize. Make sure that you find like-minded people. The second thing is to read, because you're going to meet people who have various different points of view on various different topics. So read as much about a topic so that when you encounter people who disagree with you, you'll be able to have a conversation rather than a breakdown of propaganda and a breakdown of that dialogue. The third thing is take responsibility. Run for office. You don't have to run for Congress, but you can run for class president, for a social club. That's really important. And number four maybe is the most important, find what you're passionate about. There are so many things that are the trends of the day in political activism. Find what you're passionate about. And number five, my close to my heart, is watch documentaries. You know, documentaries can give you an insight into people's lives, insight into the workings of their life as a everyday basis. So we really recommend to see our documentary. And you can see it on Amazon Prime. You can see it on Roku, Plex, and Tubi TV. But those are the five things we recommend to them. But finding out what you're passionate about is extremely, extremely important.
Well, thank you for making this documentary. It is so chilling, gripping, compelling, and it's striking a chord with so many. Very well done. It's a pleasure talking with you. Congratulations.
A pleasure talking with you as well, Kendall. Thank you so much. All the best. Bye-bye.
To you as well. And again, the film, The Day I Had to Grow Up, can be found on Tubi TV, or you can learn more at the website you see right there, thedaydocumentary.com. Make sure you check it out.